Hello friends, welcome to YouTube channel Electronics. Electrical appliances become an integral part of our life. If we observe the tags or stickers that are attached to their body, you may find their electrical specifications. These specifications are very important. Today we will discuss about three most important terms very often used in electricity, namely current, voltage and power. We will also learn about what exactly is the relationship between them. Let's start with current. What is current? Electrical current is defined as the rate of flow of electrical charge or electrons. First, let us discuss what is charge. All materials are composed of very small particles called atoms. The atoms are the building bricks of all the materials. The structure of an atom looks like this. An atom consists central nucleus of positive charge. Around the nucleus, there are different circular paths called orbits, in which negatively charged electrons move. The negatively charged electrons can move only in certain permitted orbits. The electrons in the outermost orbit are called valence electrons. In certain materials, the valence electrons is loosely attached with the nucleus. And even at normal temperature, some of the valence electrons may come out of the atom's orbit and becomes free electrons. In fact, these negatively charged free electrons are responsible for conduction of electricity in materials like copper, gold and aluminium because they have many free electrons. While the normal motion of free electrons in a conductor is random, with no particular direction or speed. If we influence these free electrons to move in a uniform direction, then that uniform motion of electrons is what we call electric current. But how we can move these free electrons in an uniform direction? This can be achieved by using a simple concept of charge. As we know, same polarity charges repels or moves away from each other. And on the other hand, opposite polarity charges attract each other. By using this concept, we can influence free electrons to move in a particular direction. If we apply some form of external charge or energy, like negative charge on one end and positive charge on the other end of a conductor, we can influence these free electrons to move in one particular direction. For free electrons to move or flow continuously through a conductor, there must be a complete and unbroken path for them to move both into and out of the conductor. However, there will never be a continuous flow of electrons within conductor unless they have a place to come from and a place to go, like electron source and electron destination. As each electron from external charge enters uniformly through a conductor, it pushes the one ahead of it, such that all electrons move together as a group. Now we know that electric current is continuous flow of electric charge. But here the question comes, how do we measure this charge? In order to know how much current is flowing through this conductor, charge is measured in coulombs, denoted by symbol Q. The electric charge of an electron is a negative charge, that is minus of 1.6 multiplied by 10 to the power of minus 19 coulombs. So 1 coulomb of charge is equal to 6.241 multiplied by 10 to the power of 18 electrons. From this figure, we can imagine that a coulomb of charge contains a very large group of electrons. An electric current is rate of flow of electric charge, means flow of a very large group of electrons. Now here the question comes, how do we measure flow of large group of electrons or current? Let's assume that we have a piece of copper wire and free electrons are flowing through this copper wire. We want to find out how many free electrons flowing through this copper wire. Just visualize placing a boundary wall into the cross section of the copper wire. And let's say it as a reference point A. So let's assume that 1 coulomb of charge is passing through this reference point in 1 second. So we can say that rate of flow of electric charge is 1 coulomb per second. That equals to 1 ampere. That is what we define as current. Rate of flow of electric charge. Current is denoted by symbol I and measured in amperes. If 10 coulombs of charge flowing in 1 second, we can say that 10 amperes current is flowing through this copper wire. To understand how electric current works, let us assume a tall container filled with water with a tap at the bottom. When you turn on the tap, look at the flow of water. If we consider this flow of water as flow of electrons or current, the rate of flow of water or current depends on how much the tap is opened. We can say this as conductivity of the material. If conductivity or the amount of free electrons in a material is high, the current flows through it also high. The rate of flow of water also depends upon how much water present in the container, as this creates pressure. Consider this volume of water as external energy. If the external energy that we have applied to influence the free electrons to move in one particular direction is high, then the current flows through the material is also high. That is how a current flows in a conductor. Now we will discuss about voltage. As we know that the normal movement of free electrons are random, with no particular direction or speed. We must apply some form of external energy or force to achieve uniform movement of free electrons in one particular direction. So let's apply energy in the form of external battery. Because of this battery, the electrons are supplied to the one end of the copper material. So the free electrons in the copper will get repelled by the same polarity charge coming from the battery, and they get attracted by the opposite charge from the positive terminal of the battery. So in this way we get flow of electrons or current from the negative terminal to the positive terminal of the battery. Metals like copper and gold have many free electrons. So the electrons are responsible for current flow from negative to positive direction. But in some semiconductors, depending on the type of dopant used, there can be positive charge carriers that flow in the opposite direction of electrons. In other cases like chemical battery, there can be flow of both positive and negative charges at same time. Therefore, there will be confusion on direction of electric current. Hence, conventional current flow was introduced, which is from positive to negative terminal of the circuit. As we have discussed that, to get uniform movement of this charge, we require some sort of external force or energy. And that energy is measured in joules. The unit of energy is joule. Let's assume we have 1 coulomb of charge in a conductor. To move this 1 coulomb of charge from negative to positive terminal, we require energy that is 1 joule. So, if 1 joule of energy is required to move 1 coulomb of charge from negative to positive terminal, then we can say that electric supply stored in the form of an electrical charge in this battery is 1 volt. The greater the voltage, the greater is its ability to push the electrons through a given circuit. The difference in voltage between any two points in a circuit is known as potential difference. So, what is voltage? Voltage is defined as the energy required to move a unit of charge from one location to another location. Let's say we have two points A and B. At point A, we have 2 coulombs of charge. So, to move this charge from A to B, we require an energy of 2 joules. So, the voltage or potential difference between point A and point B can be defined as 2 joules per 2 coulombs. that equals to 1 volt. The unit of potential difference or voltage is volt, denoted by symbol V. The higher the energy required to move charge from one point to the another point, the higher will be the potential difference. If we apply a 10 joules of energy instead of 2 joules to move 2 coulombs of charge from point A to point B, so the voltage or potential difference between these two points will be 10 joules per 2 coulombs, that equals to 5 volts. Here we can say that the greater the voltage, the greater is its ability to push the charge from one point to other point. Let us discuss voltage with some examples. Assume that two water tanks fitted with a tap at the bottom. The amount of water flowing through the tap depends upon the volume of water present in the container, as this applies a pressure. Here consider volume of water as a voltage, pressure as energy, and water flow as current or moment of charge. If we apply a high amount of voltage, then we can generate a high pressure or energy, so that we can able to have faster moment of charge. Let's take another example. We have a ball in our hand and we want to throw this ball from the ground to the top of this building, which is having 10 meters of height. So for this we need some energy. Let's say we require an energy of E1. If you want to throw the same ball from ground to the top of other building, which is 20 meters high, to fulfill this task we need more energy than the first case. Let's say we require energy E2. Here we can say that energy E2 is greater than E1. If we compare this example with voltage, the higher the difference between two points, the greater the amount of voltage required to move charge from one point to other. Likewise, the higher the potential difference between two points, more amount of energy is required to move charge from one point to other. That's all about voltage. Now we will discuss about power. What is power? The power is defined as the rate at which the energy is transferred or consumed in the system per unit time. Power is denoted by symbol P and it can be mathematically expressed as energy by time, the rate at which energy is consumed or supplied in the system. As we know, energy is measured in joules. Here, time is measured in seconds. So, it is defined by unit joules per second or watt. Power is measured in watts, denoted by symbol W. While the voltage mathematically written as energy required to move a unit of charge, that is V equal to E by Q. And current can be defined as rate of flow of electric charge, that is I equals to Q by T. Let us discuss power with example. Assume that 2 coulombs of charge is at point A and the energy required to move this charge from point A to point B is 10 joules and the time taken to complete this task is 10 seconds. So here the power required to complete this task is energy by time, that equals to 10 joules of energy per 2 coulombs of charge divided by 10 seconds of time per 2 coulombs of charge. That gives 5 joules per 5 seconds. That equals to 1 watt. Now let's generalize this term to calculate power. Suppose if we require E joules of energy to move Q coulombs of charge and the time taken for this task is T seconds, so we can write power as energy per charge E by Q divided by time per charge T by Q. That equals to E by Q multiplied with Q by T. So here E by Q is nothing but voltage, that is energy required to move a unit of charge, and Q by T is nothing but current I, that is rate of flow of electrical charge. So we can write power as product of voltage and current. So power P equal to V multiplied by I. This is very useful relationship between power, voltage and current. Power is defined as the rate at which the energy is supplied or consumed in the system. So the power is either consumed or supplied in the electrical circuit. But how to know whether an element in electrical circuit is supplying or consuming power. This can be found out by using sign convention. Let's say we have one element and voltage between its two terminals is V. So if the current I is flowing into the positive terminal of that element, then we can say that the element is consuming or dissipating power. And if the current I is flowing out of the positive terminal of that element, then we can say that the element is supplying or producing power. Let's discuss this sign convention with one example. Current is like water. It always flows from higher volume or elevation to the lower volume or elevation. If you have connected two voltage sources through a resistor, one voltage source of 10 volts and the other of 5 volts, the current will flow from higher potential to the lower potential like water. Here, our current flows like this. Let's say the voltage drop across resistor R is VR. Let's apply the sign convention across all elements. In 10 volts voltage source, the current is flowing out of the positive terminal. That means this element is supplying or producing power. In 5 volts voltage source, the current is flowing into the positive terminal, so it is consuming or dissipating power. And in resistor R also, the current is entering into the positive terminal. That means it is also consuming power. So here in this circuit, the 10 volt source is supplying power and resistor and 5 volt sources are consuming power. By using this sign convention method, we can find which element is supplying power and which one is consuming power in any electrical network. For example, the power in electrical circuit is consumed by the elements like lights and heaters. They absorb the electrical power and convert it into light or heat. The higher the value or rating in watts, the more electrical power they are likely to consume. The electrical power can be produced or supplied by batteries or generators. Here also, the higher their rating, the more power they can produce. If we superimpose the three electrical quantities, power, voltage and current into a triangle, this can be called as power triangle with power at top and current and voltage at bottom. This gives us the following combinations of the equations. To find out the various individual quantities, this is the relationship between voltage, current and power in any electrical circuits. If the calculated power is positive in value, then the respective element is absorbing the power. But if the calculated power is negative in value, the respective element is producing or supplying power. Here is a summary of what we have learned in this video. Power is product of voltage and current. Current is denoted by symbol I. Its unit is ampere and mathematically represented as I equals to Q by T. That is rate of flow of electrical charge. Voltage is denoted by symbol V. Its unit is volt and mathematically represented by V equals to E by Q. That is energy required to move a unit of charge. Power is denoted by symbol P. Its unit is watt and mathematically represented as P equals to E by T. That is rate at which the energy is transferred or consumed in the system. That's all about current, voltage and power. So if you have learned from this video, please do mention them in the comment section below. Thanks for watching this video. If you like this video, please click the like button. Help others to learn by sharing this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel and turn on notifications for more such videos. My next video about what is resistor. Have a nice day.